Got another workout for you today, so let's get to it. Before we get started, I do want to make sure everybody warms up before you do anything, at least 3 to 5 minutes. I will post a link in the bottom of the description of this workout, as well as it should be popping up in the corner right about now or just a little bit before of a workout that a warm up that I've done that you guys can do right before this workout. Please make sure you're warmed up so that you do not injure yourself. All right, let's get to this. So what I have today are 3 upper body, 3 lower body, 3 core, and 3 cardio. Very similar to the 4 corners workout that I did a few weeks ago. We're going to do reps. We're going to start with a full round of the whole workout with 20 reps. Then we're going to do a full round with 15 and then a full round with 10. And then you'll be done. Time to stretch it out. Move on with your day. All right, so we're going to do our first round at the same time as we go through the exercises. That way we get to this quicker and get through it. So before we get started as well, let's make sure we have everything we need. You need a set of medium, possibly set of heavy weights, a stability ball if you have one. If you don't, I can provide you with a modification for the exercise using weights. And a mat if you're able to use that. I mean, you can use the floor if you want to lay on the floor. It's no big deal. Maybe a little bit more comfortable on a mat. That's up to you. And some kind of raised surface. Now, it could be as simple as I have a box right here that I put a jar in just to keep it steady. Just something that you can tap your toes on. You're not standing on it or anything or jumping on it. So put this right here out of the way. Hoping you can still see it a little bit. Yep. Awesome. All right, so let's get started. We're going to start with some shoulder press. You want to grab those medium to heavy weights. Let me start my workout here real quick on my fitness tracker. All right, so we're going to start with shoulder press. Make sure when you grab the weights, also, you're not picking them up with your back. Bend down and grab them with your legs, just like people tell you when you're doing things at work. All right, so arms up right here. You want your arms starting at 90 degrees. Pushing straight overhead, back down. Now we're doing 20 reps. Good. Make sure too, we're not zipping through all of this. You're going quickly up and resisting down. Make sure you're breathing, not holding your breath. I believe that's 10. Good, it's not about how fast we get it done. As you do these, make sure you're keeping that core nice and tight. You're not arching as you push overhead. Hips are tucked underneath. Belly is tight. All right, I think that's 20. I got almost to the end and lost count. All right, now we have single arm rows. All right, so I'm going to use a kettlebell because that's the weight that I have that's heavy enough. All right, let me switch this direction so you can see. Get in that lunge position, elbow on your knee for support of your back. You're going to pull back quick, resist down. Sometimes I like single arm rows better just because you're able to lift a little bit heavier. Trying to remember to count on my hand because I am terrible at keeping track of counting, especially if I'm talking. All right, we gotta switch to the other side. It's the only bad part about single arm rows is they take a longer time. Also, I do not have any music on here. I apologize for that. I don't want to get in trouble with any internet police for copyright issues, so please make sure to play some workout music in the back for yourself. That way you can pick whatever you like, because I tend to like some girly music if any of y'all have been to my class. I think that was 15. Good. All right. Done with those single arm rows. Now we're going to do chest press. So I'm going to actually have you get on the ground, on your mat. tried to line up all our exercises that were on the ground together so that we weren't getting up and down. Scoot this a little bit away from the wall. All right, lay down on the back. Now, if you have some kind of step or something where it's a little raised, that'll be a little easier for you because then your arms aren't resting on the ground. So try to avoid them resting on the ground if you can. But you're going to push up. Now, if the weights that you have aren't quite heavy enough to make this hard enough, what you can do is do single arm chest press, double the weights in your hand, or like I could use the kettlebell and do single arm. I wish I had two. I need to get some heavier weights. And I'm not going to lie, I think I've lost count of probably around 10, so we'll start there, 11. 12, remember we're doing sets of 20, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. All right, now we're still here on the ground. So the next thing we're going to do is our stability ball hamstring curls. All right, now if you don't want to do these, what I'll have you guys do, y'all stay on the ground if you're going to do them. RDLs, weights in those hands, bending at the hips just like a Barbie doll. Stick that booty back. Back is flat. Standing straight back up. All right? So that's your modification to get those hamstrings going. Stability ball, hammy curl. Lay down. Feet right on top of the ball. I'm sorry that you can't see that, but they are right on top of the ball. Then I'm going to lift my hips, okay? You have your hands here to help with balance. If you're real good, you can take those hands off the ground. I'm not that good. I'm going to crunch those legs in. Pull your heels to your booty. Keep those hips up. If you need to stop real quick and readjust those feet, sometimes they slip off a little bit. Those 10. Good. All right. So since we're on the ground, I am going to have you sit up. We're going to do pendulums. All right. So you're going to be on your knees. This one, you probably want some kind of cushion under your knees, even if you don't have a mat, a blanket or something. And you're going to hold that core nice and tight. And you're going to lean back as far as you can until you can't come up anymore. All right. Just to that point where if you went any farther, you couldn't get up. And make sure your knees are right under your hips, not way out here. All right, right under those hips, core is tight, squeezing those hips under you, belly tight, leaning back. All right, if this does hurt, just do some regular squats. That is fine. Make sure as you do this, you're not swaying in your back, you're not sitting. All right. Good job. About 10. Now with these, especially in the next couple rounds as we go down in weight, you're welcome to add weight to it. Just make sure your form is correct before you do anything. If you notice yourself swaying at all, please do not add weight. Get the form right first. But what I would do is hold it right here under your chin. That's going to give you the most resistance. If you hold it down here at your hips, it's really not going to do very much. All right. I'm thinking that's about 20. I'm not going to lie. Again, I lost count. But make sure you did 20. I gave you some extra time in there. All right, now hop on up. I'm going to just move my weights out of the way a little bit. I tried to put them where you guys could see them, but I'm running out of room over here. So we have curtsy squats, lunges, whatever you want to call them. Basically, what you're going to do, make sure you have space side to side. You're going to step behind and squat down. Ooh, my hamstrings are feeling the stability ball curls. Make sure those knees are in a pocket. What I see people do sometimes is, I don't really know how it happens, but they only bend that front knee. You are bending both knees. All right. And we are doing 20 each side. And guess what? I've lost track. So I'm going to say that was 9. This is 10. If you guys know I'm wrong because you're better at counting than me, just make sure you use that time where I'm chatting to do those extras that I clearly have missed. Which, guess what? I lost count again. Really need to work on counting on my fingers. Alright, so if you guys have any idea how many I actually did, let me know. Alright, let's get down the ground for our core work. Make sure you guys can see me, okay? Alright, two ab and one back. So, start with alternating toe touches. Feet spread apart in the air, and you're going to reach for those shoelaces. Keep those legs tight. Try to keep them from switching. Good. All right. Definitely moved a little bit on the mat. All right. Now we're going to do single leg pike ups. All right. Now these can be challenging. So if you need to take the number down instead of making it 20 each side, you can do 20 total, but see if we can do it. So you're going to extend. I do have a stability ball in the way over here. Let me kick that out. Oops. All right. Extend as tall as you can. And you're going to tap up, V up, and come back down. V up. Make sure you're pulling your chest off the ground. It's not this. All right, that's still going to do something if you can't get all the way up. But try to get all the way up. Oh man, this is only 10 each side. 10 more to go. First round's the longest. Keep pushing, you guys. 15. Three more each side. We can do it. Come on. I know it hurts. Let's crank it out. Woo, tight, 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 tight. One more. Come on. All right. Woo. Done with those. Now we get bridges. Oh, I like these. These give me a little bit of a rest. All right. Feet close to your butt. You're going to lift, squeeze that back. Now, if you wanted to, cross on top and do single leg. And do 10 on each side. You can do that. Good. Switch sides if you want to, if you did single leg. Good. All right. Hop on up. If you need a quick sip of water, grab it. We got our cardio. I'm going to move this mat out of the way just while we finish cardio. All right. You want to grab that box, okay? Wherever you need to put it, we're going to do toe taps. All right. So typically in a classroom setting, I would do this on a step. You're basically just going to tap your toes up and down. It's a soccer drill if anybody's played soccer before. All right, so we're going to do 20 each side. So get those arms in. All right. It's a little easier when it's a little more stable. We have in and out jumps, all right? So you're going to jump out to a squat and back up to the top. 20 of those, all right? make sure the weight's in those heels. Good, 20. All right, and I save the best for last. Move my equipment out of the way here. Burpees, 20. It's our only set of 20 that we have to do. All right, so sit two. I'm gonna try to do it facing you, but I might have to turn sideways. Jump up, hit the ground, out, in. I'm hoping I don't miss count on these. I don't wanna do any more than I have to. Almost to 10. Here's 10. If you can, try to drop it to the ground for the last 10. Down. Come up. Make sure when you come up, try not to worm up. All right. You can push straight up. It's not exactly quite like a push-up. You are working those muscles, but it's still using your whole body. I believe that's 16. Whew, come on. 18. 19. Come on, last one. 20. All right, round one is done, you guys. Great job. Now, I posted the workout in the description of this. So what I want y'all to do, instead of making a super long video and y'all having to watch the whole thing, I'll let y'all do that on your own. You can go back and replay it through for the next two rounds, but remember, you're taking it down from 20 rounds the first round. You're doing 20 reps the first round. Next round is 15 reps, so it'll go a bit faster. And that last round is only 10 reps. So as you go down in reps, see if there's a way you can take it up in challenge. Whether it's jumping higher in the cardio or faster, lifting a heavier weight, going a little bit lower on whatever curtsy squat it is. Find a way to make it a little more challenging for yourself each and every time you do it. All right, now with that being said, once you are done, please make sure you cool down before you get on the ground and stretch, or before you stretch at all. Make sure you bring that heart rate down, okay? So if you're at home, that might just mean going for a 3 to 5 minute walk. Maybe even just around your backyard, okay? Or just walking around your house for a few minutes. Just make sure you bring that heart rate down before you stop and stand still so we don't drop your heart rate too fast. Not good for you to do that. All right, so do that, and then I want you to get a good stretch, which hopefully soon I'll be posting a stretch video for you guys to follow. Just a post-workout 5-minute stretch. It's the exact same thing I do in all my classes. All right, well, I hope you guys had a great workout and also have a great rest of the workout, and have a great day, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Thanks, guys.